Thank you, thank you. So this room is filled with lots of fun people and fun families, and where I work, there's a lot of families. I get four generations. There's a couple of generations right back there, see? We've got grandkids, great-grandkids, parents, grandparents, great-grandparents. It's really a community of family. And not everybody has that. Me, for instance, I'm still close with my family, but they're all back in Michigan. Michael, you're from Mississippi, and your family is where? Mississippi. Louisiana. There you go. Clifford, you moved away. Your family's all back in Oregon. Tom's a local, so, you know, he doesn't count. Bill's a local, he doesn't count. You guys don't count. Sorry, you count in my heart. But the point I'm making is that some people have that kind of safety net and that connection that makes them feel part of a community. Where I work, the grill, we had a really fun night one night. Again, I'm a magnet. I don't know how it happens. It just does. So Carl Reiner, his wife Estelle, Anne Bancroft and Mel Brooks were sitting in a booth, right? And you young kids can look that up on Wikipedia. So I was like, oh, this is going to be good. This is great. And I had just seen a PBS special the night before on all the comedic icons of the era, and Carol Burnett was part of that panel, and she was sitting in the booth right behind them. So being the magnet now that I am, I said, you know, your buddy is sitting right behind you. Who? Carol Burnett. What? So they all come in and they all squish into one booth, and they're all squished into one booth and singing and telling jokes and laughing at the top of their lungs. And the other guests were scandalized and horrified until they found out who it was. And they were like, oh my gosh, it's Anne Bancroft and Mel Brooks and Carol Reiner and Estelle Reiner and Carol Burnett. So that was a really cool, fun night, I have to say. That one goes down in the history books. Sadly, both Anne Bancroft and Estelle Reiner have left us, and so now Carl and Mel are widowers. Carl, I don't see him so often. I think he stays home, but Mel still gets out. He's such a doll. He's so sweet. If anybody's ever met him, he's just the nicest person. He's a mensch. And he comes in with his son, and he'll order dinner, and whatever he orders, he eats half of it and takes the other half back to Carl. They have dinner together. And every time he comes in, he always makes sure that Carl gets something to eat, and he takes it back, and they watch old movies and sit at TV tables and hang out. That's true friendship. In the city, me and my husband liked living there. It's been years since the kids have grown, life of their own left us alone. John and Linda live in Omaha. Joe, he's somewhere on the road. We lost Davy in the Korean War. Still don't know what for. Don't matter anymore. You know that old trees just grow stronger, and old rivers grow wilder every day. But old people, they just grow lonesome, waiting for someone to say hello in there, hello. Husband, we don't talk much anymore. He sits and stares through the back door screen, and all the new sometimes just repeats itself like some forgotten dream that we've both seen. Someday I'll go and call up Judy. We work together at the factory. Oh, but what will I say when she asks what's new, saying nothing, what's with you, nothing much to do. You know that old trees just grow stronger, and old rivers grow wilder every day. But old people, they just grow lonesome, waiting for someone to say hello in there. Hello. So if you're walking down the street sometimes, and you should spot some hollow ancient eyes, don't you pass them by and stare as if you didn't care. Say hello in Thank you. Thank you, Mitch Ellis. Thank you.